different. So you will just pay maximum attention where you don't understand us, okay? Because I'm a specialist in a way. Okay? Okay, you follow me, don't touch anything until you are told. So when the sun is in the northern hemisphere, we use the southern dome for observation. When it shifts to the southern hemisphere, tropical Capricorn, we use the northern dome for observation. Okay? So in which hemisphere is the sun right now? Depending on the dome we are using. We are using the sun. In which hemisphere is the sun?
Northern.
Yeah, it's in the northern hemisphere. Okay? Yeah. Can you mention some of the dedicated weather instruments that are kept here? Yes?
Six.
Yeah, yeah, a 6 thermometer, that is a combination of maximum and minimum thermometer.
Sunshine recorder.
Sunshine recorder, is it?
No,
barometer for air pressure or atmospheric pressure, another one. Hygrometer for relative humidity, okay? Expressed in percentage form, okay? So we measure humidity in percentage. Those are the units, okay? Yeah. Here we have got several types of thermometer, and don't push your friends, okay?
Okay,
so this is an ordinary rain gauge. It uses a measuring setting for its performance. A digital rain gauge uses a computer for retrieving the amount of rainfall received, and an automatic rain gauge uses a graph paper for plotting the amount of rainfall received. Okay? So it has rained, I think. So let's see. This is a funnel. Abaganda bakaita kazindazi. It draws the raindrops into the collecting bottle. Okay. We also have the collecting bottle. I think you can see what is it. For collecting the amount of rainfall received. We also have an overflow can. An overflow can. It's like a headmaster at a school. And the deputy. When the headmaster is not there, the deputy can play the role of the what? Of the headmaster. Okay? So in the case the bottle is full, the rest can be collected using, you see, an overflow can. That one is called a tight metal casing for holding this one. So it has rained, okay? So you pull out the collecting bottle, you pour the amount of rainfall received into a transparent measuring cylinder. Up to the last drop, you make sure you empty this bottle. So because it's much, you keep pouring. Whenever it reaches 10 millimeters, you record and pour like that until it gets so. At the end of the day, you just total, you sum up. Yeah. So who can read for us? Rainfall is measured in a millimeter because a millimeter is the smallest unit of measurement. 5 millimeters. Good. And we also measure the depth of how far it has gone into the ground before we can advise farmers whether to plant or not to do what? To plant. Or whether to irrigate their crops or not to do what?
Irrigate.
Yeah, it is suspended 30 centimeter or 1 foot above the ground to avoid water splash, okay? We keep short grass around the rain gauge to control soil
erosion.
Okay, let's go and look at that one.
You can just make a big circle, circle the table.
So have you done, have you ever heard of the word matter?
No.
Yes.
What is meant by the term matter?
Matter is energy by space
and has weight. We have 3 states of matter. We have the liquid, and
the gaseous state.
Yeah. The process in which liquid state turns into gaseous state is quite to us. Yes. Yes. Which process is that?
Evaporation.
Evaporation, yes, that is it. It's called evaporation. So this one is called an evaporation. It's used for measuring the amount of water vapor that escapes into the atmosphere from water bodies. It reaches at a point called the condensation point. It condenses to form clouds. And it's from the formation of clouds that we see the funnel you have the graph paper, which is wrapped on a clock-driven drum. This one is called a clock-driven drum because it rotates clockwise, okay?
Mm.
We also have a plotting pen because you cannot plot men as a pen or pen. This one is called a plotting pen. So whenever it rains, the raindrop passes through the funnel. It enters through these two tubes, and because of the pressure, forces this pen to keep moving up and down. Where it is floating on the graph, so the clock-driven drum keeps on rotating clockwise while the pen is floating on the clock-driven on the graph. Okay. So after a week, you pluck out the graph paper. After plucking out, you add the amount of rainfall received on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday for the whole week. And you get the total amount of rainfall received in what?
Mm-hmm.
The solar radiation is that one. It's called the solar limiter. That one is the solar limiter. Oh, it's sunshiny sense.
Time comes when you've been training with your instructor or your teacher flying. The moment comes whereby he or she thinks you can fly now on your own. So the first flight you have alone is called a solo. We also do it here. And you know, guess what happens after the solo? When you land, the culture is we pour on you water. So we tell you if you have baggage like phones and what, remove them, leave them there. If you don't want your shoes to get wet, remove your shoes. Then we shower you with water. It's like we are baptizing you. Like, you know, we are removing all the curses you have been having. So that's what they call a solo. So that lady goes for a solo. She lands. She's happy. She gets her phone to make a phone call at home. She was from Sudan. So she did not switch off everything from the other side. So as she was making a phone call, she came in front and then happened to tap this propeller. So it just cranked once. Guess what she was? She was in two pieces. And you know, with our social media, even before the school could inform the parents, they already got them to know. People took photos and then started distributing those photos.
Are you seeing?
Because now phones, you find an accident has happened, instead of coming to the father's, so like, you know, take to rush them to the hospital, what? Someone is taking a selfie. When someone is dying, there is dying there, someone is taking a selfie. So that's what they are doing. For them, they try to do, which wasn't good. So this propeller is very, very dangerous. So aside with the incident part, we should know what we are going to talk about.
Good.
And what we are going to talk about involves transport. Do you know what transport is?
Yes.
Who can tell us by your hands?
Transport is a move that people from one place to another.
Transport is a movement of people all the way to one place. All of you are correct. Go here, left.
Goods.
Yeah. Transport is a movement of people, they are goods from one place to another. You can either be goods transported alone or even you can go with your goods or you can transport goods alone from one place to another. Yeah, so we have known what transport is. All of us, we have gotten what transport is, okay?
Yes.
Then we come to how many types of transport do we have? How many types of transport do we have? Five. Is there anyone with a different answer? Maybe you know two. Four. Who has another one? Yeah, I know why.
B, boys and girls, listen up. You can be anything in the world, and God we trust. An architect, doctor, maybe an actress, but nothing comes easy. It takes much practice. Like, I met a woman who's becoming a star. She was very beautiful, leaving people in awe. Singing songs, Lena Horne, but the younger version. Hung with the wrong person, got a stronger than her. When cocaine, sniffing up drugs, all in her nose. Could have died so young, now looks ugly and old. No fun, cause now when she reaches for hugs, people hold their breath, cause she smells of corrosion and death. Watch the company you keep and the crowd you bring. Cause they came to do drugs and you came to sing. So if you're gonna be the best, I'ma tell you how. Put your hand in the air and take the vow. I know I can,
I know I can
be what I wanna be,
be what I wanna be.
If I work hard at it,
if I work hard at it,
I'll be where I wanna be. Boys and girls, listen again. This is for grown looking girls who's only 10. The ones who watch.
From the
interior,
the falls that John Hanning speaks so in 1862, naming going home, the record falls after the president of the Royal Society.
Have you seen it? How many have seen it?
That's brown.
Have you seen it?
No.
Yes. You know the river is shared by two tribes, the Wasoga and the Baganda. This is the side for Wasoga and that is the side for Baganda. So where I see the peninsula, that is the spot where John speaks to discover the source of river Nile. And then the actual source of river Nile, which you come to see, you can't see it from here. They show you the direction where it is. Are you seeing the two islands over there?
One of
them. That first island is a man-made island.
Yes,
and it came about as they were moving the cornfields around this place. The materials that were here, they were being dumped around that place, leaving this formation. And then the one with the graphite house, that one is a natural island. And so the actual source of River Nile is in between those two islands there, where the water comes from underground by the springs. And the springs contribute 30% to the River Nile water, and then 70% comes from Lake Victoria, the other side. Then in this river, there is a variety of fish species like tilapia, nile perch, silverfish, among others. Yes.
Can be up in the club with fake ID. Careful, for you meet a man with HIV. You can host a TV like Oprah Winfrey. Whatever you decide, be careful, some men be rapists, so act your age, don't pretend to be older than you are. Give yourself time to grow. You're thinking he can give you wealth, but so young boys, you can use a lot of help, you know. You're thinking life's all about smoking weed and ice. You don't wanna be my age and can't read and write, begging different women for a place to sleep at night. Smart boy.
I'm gonna go get it.